What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to the Illinois Tech Dynasty. Conference play is about to begin for the Illinois Tech Wolfpack as the Broncos of Western Michigan have come to town. And let's see if the Wolfpack can find their second win of the season at home. Illinois Tech picked up their first program win 2 weeks ago with a win against Northwestern and had 2 weeks to prepare for Western Michigan, who are also looking for their second win of the season. Still really early on in the season, but a conference win here for Illinois Tech could mean big things for their momentum for the rest of the year. Is Lucas Baker from the goal line on the return? He's a new return man for Illinois Tech, and he's brought down after a 19-yard gain, and it doesn't seem like it's the return guy's not doing a good job returning. It's this blocking up front that's not spring these kick returners free. First and 10, Caden Garrett gets the football running right side, led by Brandon Archer, and nowhere to go. He's dropped behind the line to get things going. That's a loss of one. Kelly from the pistol throws quickly to the flat. That's Brandon Archer trying to loop back around, and Archer can't find anywhere to go. It's third and long already for the Wolfpack. Kelly from the shotgun. They go five wide. Time to throw. Kelly looks downfield. That's Archer again. Past midfield, and Archer brought down after a 33-yard gain. Illinois Tech finally able to spread the field against zone coverage. We have not seen them do that a lot this season, and that's mainly because of the talent they've been playing so far this year. But Western Michigan, their secondary, not as good as Northwestern, and definitely not as good as North Carolina's. First and 10 for Illinois Tech, and as Caden Garrett getting the football once again, running right side. Caden Garrett trying to initiate contact. He's a power back, got to use that power. Third and 4. Kelly throws quickly to the flat for Brandon Archer once again, and Archer is leveled and kept shy of a first down. It's fourth down. But no surprise here, Wolfpack staying on the field on offense, and is Caden Garrett picking up 3 yards, and that'll move the chains for Illinois Tech. First and 10, they're getting close to field goal range. First and 10, Archer the man in motion once again. This is going to be a give left side for Garrick, and the blocking up front just has not been good enough to keep this ground game consistent. Second down and 10, Kelly time to throw, looks for Angel Parker, tight throw into a tight window, but that's going to be dropped by Parker. Now it's third and 10 for Illinois Tech. Kelly looking, throws under pressure. That ball is incomplete, and that's fourth down, and the Wolfpack will punt. Western Michigan takes the field on offense, and it's Zach Terrell from the shotgun throwing left side. He's got Thompson, and there was no Wolfpack defenders in that area. He could have kept going if he had stayed in bounds. First and 10, man in motion is the tight end, Bezerra. That's a give right side to Jamari Bogan, the running back, and Jamari Bogan passing midfield, tracked down from behind by Hunter. That's a first down for Western Michigan. Two plays, two first downs. Here goes a pass from Terrell right side for Ernsberger, the tight end, and he gets a first down. Another tackle there by Gabe Hunter. First and 10, Terrell rolls out to his left. He will set and throw right side in, out of bounds. Call that one a win for the defense. It's second and 10. Zach Terrell option right side. Jamari Bogan is tracked down by Hunter. Nice play behind the line. He's been known to miss tackles, but it's third and long for Western Michigan. They're going to go screen right side. Hunter is there to cover, and down goes Terrell. That's a nice play there by Cam Wolf, and the Broncos are forced to punt. First and 10 for Illinois Tech, going back on offense, trying to get past the 25, and that's a nice run there by Caden Garrick. Blocking wasn't great, but a good job getting upfield. Kelly from the pistol again, this time looking to throw. He's got Archer downfield. He gets past the defense, and Brandon Archer going to go into the end zone for a 74-yard touchdown. He's got two of the longest plays Illinois Tech has had all season long. Already over 100 yards for Archer. This is an incredible performance from him in this first quarter. Illinois Tech leads by 7. Terrell from under center is pressured, nearly brought down behind the line by Xavier Hunter. That'll bring up second down. Terrell from the shotgun on second down keeps it, runs up the middle. Solid gain that time to make it third and short for Western Michigan. Can this Illinois Tech defense get these guys off the field? Terrell throws from the shotgun underneath. That's Ernsberger with the catch, and Jamie Horn laid a big hit, but the ball didn't get popped free. First down, Western Michigan. Terrell throws left side. He's got Thompson again. Thompson breaks away from Reed, but can't get away from Reeves. If he did, that 20-yard gain might have turned into a touchdown. First and 10, Terrell goes play action, throws, and what a play from Reeves. Good job in man coverage, knocks the ball away. It's second and 10. Zach Terrell from under center, pressured, and is kind of scrambling around in the backfield there. That's a 5-yard catch by Ernsberger. That'll bring up 3rd and 5 for Western Michigan. They'll go to the screen once again. Hunter is there again. This time, Hunter's got the pick, and it's going to be run back, and Hunter's rep down, but the ball comes free, and it's Hunter there on the recovery. So the big play there from Hunter gets the ball back to the Illinois Tech offense, almost gave it back to Western Michigan. That play would be reviewed, but as you can see, elbow is down by contact. That fumble would be reversed. Illinois Tech back on offense from the 35. That's Caden Garrett trying to find room up the middle. Once again, only a 3-yard gain, as he's had a hard time running so far this game. 6 carries and 14 yards. 3rd down and 7. Kelly throws left side. He's got Vandenberg crossing midfield. 13-yard gain. And the Wolfpack move the chains. Illinois Tech from the shotgun. Anthony Bishop checks in for the first time today. Cuts up field and will fight ahead for a 7-yard gain. Bishop the speedster, Caden Garrick the power back, back to Garrick on 2nd down. Garrick trying to power his way past the marker, and he's got a 4-yard gain, good enough for a 1st down. Bunch right for the Wolfpack on 1st and 10. Kelly looks underneath. He's got McKnight, who makes a tough catch in traffic. Kind of seems like McKnight can't make those grabs when the pressure's on, but when the pressure's not on, he's pretty good at making those receptions. Read option on 2nd down. SA gave up the middle to Caden Garrick, and now it's 3rd and 3. For Illinois Tech, Kelly goes to the screen. That's Baker trying to get back to the outside. If he gets around the numbers, he is in for a touchdown, but a 1st down regardless. 5 wide set for Illinois Tech on 2nd and 10 with 3 minutes to go in the quarter. Kelly fires right side for Vandenberg, and that is well covered. That'll bring up 3rd and 10. Illinois Tech staying 5 wide on 3rd and 10, but Archer checks in as a receiver. Kelly throws his way, thrown in a double coverage, and he's picked off by Beal. And Beal trying to run this one back, tripped up at the 30. And Illinois Tech just gives the ball right back to Western Michigan. And they've got a chance to make something happen before halftime. Terrell throws underneath. That's Henry with the catch. And Henry lowers the shoulder, picks up a 14-yard gain in the 1st down for the Broncos. 2nd down and 9, they go read option. Terrell carries right side, and if for some reason guys can't get off their blocks, Terrell inside the red zone, he's brought down inside the 10, and that's a touchdown saving tackle by Deion Reeves. Got to do better on defense. 1st and goal, Terrell will stay in the pocket, throws right side for Bogan, and that's going to be thrown too short. That's going to bring up 2nd down and goal. I formation for the Broncos, give to Bogan up the middle, and Bogan stops short after a 2-yard gain. That'll bring up 3rd and goal for Western Michigan. Terrell from under center fires quickly left side, and that is too far in front of Thompson. That'll bring up 4th and goal, and Western Michigan has a chance to get on the board here with a field goal, but it's going to be Flacco. It's a fake Flacco trying to run, brought down by Orton, and that's going to be a turnover. That is 3 turnovers going back-to-back-to-back, keeping this game at a 7-point difference. And that was a really good play call by the special teams coordinator, keeping these guys aware for that fake field goal. 2nd and 10, Illinois Tech inside the 5-yard line. And there goes Bishop trying to cut free. Nice job there getting the 1st down. Maybe 1 broken tackle away from taking that one to the house. 1st and 10, 39 seconds left. Kelly throws left side, and he's looking for Shelton, but he finds the sideline. Not a great throw there from Kelly. 37 seconds left, still 2 timeouts. Quick throw to the flat for McKnight, and that gets batted down at the line of scrimmage. And now it's 3rd and 10. For Illinois Tech, Kelly from the pistol once again looks to throw right side. They brought a corner on the blitz, and T.C. Shelton gets out of bounds. That'll stop the clock. But now 3rd and 7, Illinois Tech facing pressure. Grayson downfield with the near catch and a near 1st down that should have put Illinois Tech in field goal range. But it's 4th down, Illinois Tech would punt, and nothing going for Western Michigan. 7-point lead for the Wolfpack heading into halftime. Not a lot of scoring in that 1st half as both teams get close to scoring but end up making some crucial mistakes in the red zone. But let's see what the Western Michigan Broncos can do here in the 2nd half as Franklin on the return cutting up field, and Franklin brought down shy of the 25-yard line. And here comes the Illinois Tech defense back on the field. They've got 2 turnovers already, trying to get a 3rd one in this 2nd half. Broncos start 5 wide. Zach Terrell throws right side for Bellamy with a good gain. That's good for 7 yards. That'll bring up 2nd and 3 for the Western Michigan Broncos. Terrell running around a lot this game as he doesn't even look to throw. That was not a design run, it didn't look like, and he picks up 8 yards and a 1st down. He's done that at least 2 or 3 times this game. 1st and 10, carry right side for Bogan, and the defense just all over the run right there. Big blitz brought in Xavier Hunter with the tackle in the backfield. That'll lose 4 yards. 5 wide set for Western Michigan once again. Zach Terrell looking left side and throws for Corey Davis. And he just moved out the way. Taylor dives in there to make a play. That's going to bring up 3rd down and 14. They go back to the screen. That's Bogan getting away from Reed, but Reeves is there again. Fourth down and seven. They'll have to punt the ball back to Baker. They've been going to the screens a lot on third down. Luckily, no one there to pick it off this time. And it's Baker from the 15-yard line. He's got speed to get around the edge. Baker passed the 25, and Baker out of bounds after a 14-yard return. And Illinois Tech back on the field from the 30-yard line. Kelly looking to throw, and there's no one open downfield. 12-yard sack. That's going to be a big loss for the Wolfpack offense. Second and 22. Bishop checks in. They go screen right side. That's how you run a screen. It's Bishop in the open field trying to break free. 13-yard gain. That'll bring up third down and eight. Four wide set for the Wolfpack. Kelly rolling out to his left side. Throws for Vandenberg, who makes the catch but came too far back. That's going to bring up fourth down. But the offense will stay on the field. Fourth and one. Give up the middle to Caden Garrick. He's got the first down. That's two for two on the day for fourth down attempts. Caden Garrick still not having a strong game. Only 2.1 yards per carry. Quick pass out to the flat. That's McKnight. 5-yard catch. That'll bring up second and medium. Illinois Tech still on the pistol. Carry left side for Caden Garrick. Look at the blocking upfield. Caden Garrick inside the 35-yard line. If he had more speed, that could have been a touchdown down the sideline. But still a pretty solid game right there. Bishop checks in. First and 10. There goes the speed. The Wolfpack needed that last run. 14-yard gain. Anthony Bishop is a burner in the open field. Third down and 9. Kelly looking for Vandenberg, who converts this time. First and goal, Illinois Tech inside the 5. And they'll come out in the shotgun, spreading out the defense. Give to Garrick at the goal line. Powers his way in. 4-yard touchdown. 13-0 lead. And it's pretty late in the third quarter. Western Michigan has to respond. And it's going to be a point after attempt here from Gonzalez. And he just, I don't know what happened there. Well, actually, I do know what happened. Because my controller is a little janky. So that right thumbstick, when you try to jerk it up sometimes, it does not work. And that time, no dice. Illinois Tech back on defense up 13-0. Terrell all day to throw. Looks left side for Corey Davis Jr. And that was a pretty tough catch in traffic. 7-yard gain. That makes it 2nd and 3. Carry right side for Bogan. Gets away from Hunter. Reeves can't make the tackle. That's a surprise. And it's Bogan up the sideline inside the 40. And finally tracked down by Thomas Corbin, the left end, after a huge run. Where's the defense on the left side of the field? Terrell throws under pressure. What a play from Gabe Hunter. What a diving attempt to knock the ball away. That could have been a touchdown. But Gabe Hunter, with a great play in man coverage, not normally known for his great man coverage ability, but that time getting the job done. That'll bring up second down. Terrell gives it to Bogan on the draw. Bogan in open space picks up a first down, 12-yard gain in his first and goal, Western Michigan. Now they're inside the 5-yard line. Second down and goal. Give left side to Franklin, the backup running back. They've got two pretty good backs on this Western Michigan team. Franklin's first carry of the game will net him 4 yards, and that was third down and goal. Western Michigan gives it back to Bogan left side, and there goes the touchdown Western Michigan has needed for a long time, but they finally get on the board and cut this lead in half. 7-13, Western Michigan will kick off with 25 seconds to go in the third quarter. Here goes Lucas Baker. Baker trying to make something happen here on the return. Cuts to the left side. He's got the speed to get away from the defense. Baker up the left sideline, past midfield, and tripped up finally at the 45-yard line. Illinois Tech back on the field on offense with a short field to work with, and the offense has moved the ball pretty well in the second half, giving it back to Bishop, and Bishop showing off the speed there. First down, that's good for about 14 or 15 yards. Ball to the 25-yard line. Garrick is out. Bishop is still in the ball game. Bishop to the outside. He's got speed to get around the edge, and Anthony Bishop, 14-yard gain again. This change of pace is too much for this Western Michigan defense. Caden Garrick, first carry of the drive, and he loses the football. Are you kidding me? There goes the second turnover of the game. And you just can't do this. You can't let your backup run well and then come in for your first carry and fumble the football. Caden Garrick giving the ball right back to Western Michigan. They have a chance to at least tie or maybe take the lead here in the fourth quarter if they make their extra point. First and 10, Terrell looking to throw. He's got Ernstberger wide open. Where is the coverage? 19-yard gain for the tight end. First and 10, Ernstberger in motion to the right side of the formation. They go play action. Terrell looking downfield. Thompson is wide open. Where is the defense? He's inside the 10. He will score. And all of a sudden, Western Michigan has tied this ball game up. This is just not acceptable for your starting corner to be doing. I don't understand this. I mean, come on, Isaiah Taylor. You got to be a little better than that. 50 play recognition. You shouldn't be getting faked out like that. Got to be better. Western Michigan leads by one, and here goes Lucas Baker with another return, trying to get the Wolfpack a short field again. This one returned from 2 yards deep. Baker towards the left side once again. Baker got room to work with, this time not getting past midfield, but still a solid gain, good for 48 yards. And here goes Anthony Bishop in the Wolfpack offense. Caden Garrett taking the seat because of the fumble, and, well, Bishop loses 3 yards on that play. Not a good job blocking by the receivers on the outside. Second and 13. Kelly from the pistol looks to throw. We'll throw this one for McKnight, and what a catch. What a throw from Kelly. That was a pretty dangerous throw, but just gets it right past the linebacker and underneath the safety who was looming the area. That was a great throw. First and 10, Illinois Tech from the 40-yard line. That's a keeper for Kelly. Kelly's showing off the wheels here. First down, could have maybe slowed down a little bit to use a block there, but still a solid gain. Good for 15 yards. Ball near the 20. Kelly going to the screen. It was set up again, but the defensive line has been knocking down these passes all day long. Third down and 8. Kelly looking to throw. Fires Vandenberg with a catch, and Travis Vandenberg with another third down conversion. Is Illinois Tech doing big things through the air this ball game? First and 10. Garrett checks back in, tries to get around the edge, and Garrett is brought down behind the line. He will lose 2. That'll bring up third down and 12 a play later, and Kelly needs to get this offense in the end zone. Kelly pressured. That ball is batted around, luckily not picked off, and Illinois Tech will settle for a field goal. Kelly just needing one more second. Nate Grayson was wide open in the back of the end zone, uncovered against cover 2. And here goes Jesus Gonzalez. This field goal is up, and it is good. And Illinois Tech, with 4 minutes to go, leads by 2 points. So they need a big defensive stop here, because that last drive, that one was not pretty. Broncos getting started from the 23-yard line. Terrell looks to throw underneath. That is Bellamy with the catch, but Bellamy coming back way too far. He loses a yard. That'll bring him second and 11. Terrell looks to throw once again. He's got Watson across the middle. Watson near the marker. 10-yard gain, and that's third and short for the Broncos. Doubt they go screen here. They don't. Terrell, time to throw. Looks right side for Watson. That bubble screen went all the way to the 50-yard line. First down, 27-yard gain. Wolfpack in trouble as this defense is getting pretty much passed on at will. Watson, another catch here. Breaks away from Gabe Hunter. Gets away from Curtis Watson inside the 15 and finally tracked down by Taylor. 39-yard gain, first and goal, Western Michigan. 2:34 to go. Terrell looking over the middle. Ernstberger is wide open, not even touched. Touchdown, Western Michigan. They fight back. They were down 13-0. All of a sudden, 20-16. Terrell throwing off the back foot. Jump ball for Corey Davis Jr. Now they lead by 6 points. 2:31 to go. Western Michigan is not out of this ball game yet. Baker has been killing them on the returns. Can he get another big one here? Baker past the 30-yard line, past the 40, past midfield. Baker still going inside Western Michigan territory, inside their 20, and finally tracked down. 83-yard return. Lucas Baker, welcome to the big leagues. I think the Wolfpack have found their answer at kick return. First and 10. That's going to be Caden Garrett carrying right side and brought down after a 6-yard gain. That's going to get Illinois Tech down to about the 10-yard line. Anthony Bishop checks in, carries upfield. Anthony Bishop inside the 5-yard line, 7-yard gain. Minute 34 left, and Illinois Tech still has plenty of time to get in the end zone here. First and goal, T.C. Shelton. 5-wide set. He moves in motion, and is Shelton in for the touchdown. The jet sweep works in the red zone. Touchdown, Wolfpack. They tie the ball game up at 22, and here goes the extra point. Can Gonzalez make this one? This one is up, and it is good. 1-point lead with 1:07 to go. This defense needs a stop. 1:03 to go for Terrell in the offense. They start 5 wide, and Terrell looking left side for Bellamy, and that ball is knocked free by Reeves. That'll bring up 2nd and 10. Ernstberger in motion on 2nd down. Terrell dropping back from under center, looks to throw, and he's working towards the left sideline. That is Keyshawn Watson again. 1st down Broncos, 13-yard gain. That'll stop the clock with 53 seconds left. Terrell looking, throws, and Horn, oh my goodness, Jamie Horn, you got to catch the ball there. That should have been the ball game. 2nd down, Terrell from the gun, looks to throw down the seam. He's got Keyshawn Watson again. He has been torching his Wolfpack defense in this 4th quarter. 2nd and 10, going back to the ground game. That is Bogan. And Western Michigan should be in field goal range here. And Illinois Tech calls their first timeout, looking to at least maybe get the ball back if they can force a fourth down. Third down and four. Bogan carries right side. Good play by Horn. That'll end up losing two. And the Wolfpack call their second timeout. Pretty long field goal for the Broncos. 49-yarder. This one is up, and it is nowhere even close. Wide right there is probably a reason why they tried that fake from so close to your field goal kicker. Must not be that good, because that was nowhere even close. And the Broncos need to try to get a stop here. They're down to their final timeout, third and 14. And Bishop carrying, they call their timeout. 17 seconds left. And Western Michigan will get the ball back here. 9 seconds left. They come out four wide. And they're sending everyone deep downfield. Quick throw by Terrell, but picked off by Taylor. The ball game is over. 2 seconds left, and Taylor shoved out of bounds. Big play there by the defense. Finally making a play. Luckily not a touchdown there. And that should do it for week four. Illinois Tech will find their second win of the season at home. And this is their first conference game of the year, so getting off to a strong footing in the conference. A close ball game, but the turnovers made the difference. If Western Michigan hadn't have gone for that fake field goal, this game probably would have been a little different. Brandon Archer, player of the game, didn't really look for him a lot in that second half. He had a great first half, but since then, not really a lot going. Illinois Tech with a huge game, absolutely huge. 23-22. There was a lot of scoring in that second half, obvious after that 7-point first half. Caden Garrett, not a bad game. Anthony Bishop in relief. He will get more carries, as you guys have wanted him to do throughout this season. Jamie Horn leads in tackles for the first time today, and we got one interception from Taylor. Unfortunately, Hunter's interception is not showing, but what a game from Lucas Baker. 51.7 yards per return. He was a game changer with those short fields he was giving us. Pretty good day on the ground for Western Michigan. Also through the air for Zach Terrell, especially going to Keyshawn Watson, who was just breaking every tackle thrown his way. But obviously, at the end of the day, this came down to missed opportunities, and that fake field goal for Western Michigan, I feel like that really hurt them the most out of anything they did this ball game. They really should have gone for that field goal. But some sad recruiting news. We have lost our first subscriber recruit. That is Christian Fernandez, corner out of, I think, Waco, Texas. So Bowling Green still leads in the division, and Toledo still leads their division. They're in the West. And we'll take a look at the top 25. We won't do this every week, but when big upsets happen, like Stanford losing to Arizona State, and then scrolling a little further down, this is always funny. Alabama being upset by Colorado State. We saw this happen in the wide receiver road to glory, and it's happened once again. Next week in week five, the Wolfpack travel to take on the Midshipmen of Navy and their number four rush offense. Illinois Tech right now has a number two rush defense, mainly because teams don't really need to run the ball against us. We're very, very weak through the air, and well, teams have kind of learned that. But expect a ton of running from Navy and that high-powered wishbone offense. Illinois Tech 2-1, Navy 2-0, and we'll see who comes away with the win in week five. Thank you all for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed. And I will see you all for the next episode of the Illinois Tech Dynasty. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like and also subscribe. And we'll see you guys next time. Have a nice day.